Hello, this is Dr. Upinder Kaur. Welcome to Physio Lectures. Today, I am going to present a topic about Guillain-Barré syndrome. From the exam point, this topic is very important. First of all, we will see about the definition of the Guillain-Barré syndrome. Guillain-Barré syndrome is an inflammatory disorder of the peripheral nerves, which are outside the brain and spinal cord. It is a rare disorder in which person's body immune system attacks own nerves. So, GBS is an inflammatory disorder in which mostly peripheral nerves are affected. In this, mostly the motor nerves are affected, but sometimes the sensory and autonomic nerves will also affected. Generally, in this, the person's own body immune system attacks the own nerves. Second definition is that it is a post-infectious polyneuropathy involving mainly motor nerve but sometimes also sensory and autonomic nerves. As the GBS is sometimes occur due to the GI infection as well as respiratory tract infection. So that's why it is also known as post-infectious polyneuropathy. There are other two names of GBS. So it is also called as an acute inflammatory demyelinating polyneuropathy, that is AIDP, and second is Landry's ascending paralysis. Now here ascending, the paralysis ascending means that it travels up the limbs from finger and toes towards the torso. Here a figure is shown that in the normal nerve, the axon is surrounded by the healthy myelin sheath. But the person having GBS, in that person, axon is surrounded by the damaged myelin sheath as shown in the figure. So generally, the myelin sheath become affected due to the body's own immune attack of own immune system. Now the epidemiology of GBS, usually it occur in the children under the 15 years of age. Overall frequency is 1.9 cases per 1 lakh population, and in gender, male is more affected as compared to the female, so male-female ratio is 1.5:1. Etiology, generally the GBS is usually follows a known specific GI infection, gastrointestinal infection which occurs due to jejuni and pylori, or respiratory infection which occurs due to the N pneumoniae, and the paralysis occur approximately usually follows a known specific in the GI or respiratory infection by approximately 10 days. Now the GI infection occurs due to the some reasons like consumption of uncooked food, unpasteurized milk and contaminated water are the main sources of gastrointestinal infection. GBS also reported following administration of vaccines like rabies, influenza, poliomyelitis, that is oral administration, and following the administration of conjugated meningococcal vaccines. So these are the some of the reasons due to which GBS occurs. Now the types of GBS, there are basically four types of GBS. First is acute inflammatory demyelinating polyradiculoneuropathy, that is AIDP. Second is acute motor axonal neuropathy, that is AMN. Third one is acute motor and sensory axonal neuropathy, that is AMSEN. And third one is Miller-Fisher syndrome, that is MFS. Now we will see about all these type of GBS one by one. So let's start with the acute inflammatory demyelinating polyradiculoneuropathy, that is AIDP. Generally this type of GBS is seen in the Europe and the North America, and in these it accounts for about 80-90% of GBS cases. Characteristic, it is characteristic by an immune-mediated attack on the myelin sheath with infiltration of the lymphocyte and macrophage with segmental stripping of myelin. So, in this type of GBS, the immune attacks on the myelin sheath which results in the segmental stripping of the myelin. Motor and sensory fibers are usually affected, simultaneously and producing the corresponding deficit. So in this type of GBS, both type of fibers are affected, that is motor as well as sensory fibers. Now the electrophysiological study shows that the slow nerve conduction velocity in cases of AIDP and there is prolonged SA. So in every type of GBS we will study about the which fibers will affected and what was the electrophysiological study shows. The second type of GBS is acute motor axonal neuropathy, that is AMAN. This type of GBS is most commonly seen in China and Japan, where 50-60% cases are related to AMAN, as opposed to the Western countries, which shows very less number of cases of AMAN, 10-20% of the cases. As the name suggests, that acute motor axonal neuropathy. So in this type, the axonal degeneration occurred due to the immune attack within the 1-2 weeks after the infection, and in these cases usually motor fibers are affected. That's why it is known as acute motor axonal neuropathy. So in this form, axonal degeneration occurred by the immune attack within 1-2 weeks after infection. Specific antibodies to axonal membranes of motor fiber attack the node of Ranvier. Now the electrophysiological study shows that there is reduction in action potential of the muscles, motor fibers, but there is a normal sensory nerve action potential and normal F wave. The third type is acute motor and sensory axonal neuropathy. This type is rare and resembles with the AMAN, except that in this the both fibers are affected, that is sensory as well as motor, while in AMAN only the motor fibers are affected. So and this type is associated with severe course and poor prognosis. The fourth one is Miller-Fisher syndrome. The involvement of cranial nerve is very distinct in the form of, in this form of GBS. So mostly the ocular motor nerves, that is oculomotor, trochlear, abducens, are affected and produce a triad of ophthalmoplegia, ataxia, and areflexia, while the electrophysiological studies are normal in case of Miller-Fisher syndrome. Now the symptoms. First symptom is that there is a pricking, pins or needle sensation in fingers, toes, ankles or wrist. Second is progressive muscle weakness, that is weakness start in the legs and then it spread to the upper body. Third is diminished reflexes. Fourth one is unsteady walking or inability to walk or climb stairs, which occurs due to the muscle weakness. The next is difficulty with facial movements, including speaking, chewing or swallowing. Next is double vision or inability to move eyes. Severe pain that may feel achy, shooting, cramp-like and may be worse at night. Difficulty with bladder or control or bowel function. Rapid heart rate, low or high BP. Difficulty in breathing. So these are the symptoms of Guillain-Barré syndrome. Now the diagnostic evaluation. Generally GBS is diagnosed by the medical history. Second, physical examination. Third is test. Test are the nerve conduction velocity test, that is NCV, CSF, cerebrospinal fluid examination and electromyography study. Now the criteria for GBS is that there is a progressive weakness in legs and arms and a reflexia. So the person comes with the history of progressive weakness in legs, arms and there is a presence of a reflexia. Features that strongly support the diagnosis are progressive of symptoms over days to 4 weeks, relatively symmetry symptoms, mild sensory symptoms and cranial nerve involvement. Treatment. First of all, I will present you about the medical treatment, then physiotherapy treatment. Medical treatment includes plasmapheresis, high dose immunoglobulin therapy, mechanical ventilator, pain control, supportive care. While the physiotherapy management, it includes the several points. First of all, that in GBS, the person's muscles become weak, so that due to the weakness, sometimes flaccid paralysis also occurs. So in these cases, the patient is bedridden. So there is a chances of respiratory complication. So first important point is respiratory care. The main aim of respiratory care is to prevent the respiratory complications. And the treatment methods are breathing exercises, chest percussion to remove the secretions, resistive inspiratory training, postural drainage 2 hourly, turning or change position. In severe cases, after removal of a ventilator and adequate expansion, effective cuffing must be taught to the patient. After respiratory care, the maintenance of circulation is very important. For this, the passive movements are given to every joint like wrist, finger, then elbow, upper limb and lower limb both. So next is effleura massage to the lower limb. Third one is prevention of pressure sores. As the patient is bedridden, so there may be chances of development of pressure sores. So early or too early change in position from supine to side lying is important. And if sores have developed, then UVR, ultraviolet radiation, is given to enhance the healing. Relief of pain is very important. For this, TENS is given, that is transcutaneous electrical nerve stimulation, and massage with the passive range of motion. Next is maintenance of normal range of movement. For this, the gentle passive movements are throughout full range of motion at least 3 times a day are given, especially at the hip, shoulder, wrist, ankle and feet. Maintenance of proper position is important. So to stabilize the patient, use sandbag and pillows. Light splint using plaster zot may be used to support the peripheral joints in comfortable and functional position during flaccid paralysis. Next is strength and endurance training. So after all this, the strength, to maintain the strength or to develop the strength is important. For this, the strengthening exercises are given to the patient, which are isometric, isotonic and isokinetic exercises. And for the endurance training, it involves the progressively increasing intensity and duration of the exercises. Functional training. Functional training includes the retraining of dressing, washing, bed mobility, transfers, and ambulation activities, which comprise a big part of the rehabilitation process. Balance and proprioception retraining in all functional activities should also be included, while the motor control can be achieved by doing PNF. Apart from this, assistive devices are given or recommended to the patients for effective and safe ambulation. So these assistive devices include wheelchairs, walking stick and quadruped, which should be made available to individuals if required in order to facilitate the safe and effective ambulation. So these is the basics about the GBS. If you like my video, then please share it and also subscribe my channel for more such videos. Thank you.